Okay, so I know this is a little bit of a different setup than my normal videos. In today's video, I want to show you how you can start your own t-shirt business in your small space. What is up, Define Squad? Welcome and welcome back to another video. It's your girl Alex at Define by Alex. Here on this channel, we're talking all things t-shirts with some lifestyle content on the side. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. So as you guys can see from where I'm at, I'm in my den. And so in my apartment, I have a one bedroom, like a den situation, like floor plan, to where this space is kind of like a two bedroom, but without the two bedroom price. Okay, so when it comes to starting your t-shirt business, I know what it's like firsthand operating from a small space. Okay, so I totally get it. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys the things that you can start using to build your own at-home t-shirt shop, especially if you have a small space and you may not have the budget right away to rent out a separate space, rent out an office, rent out a warehouse, whatever it may be. I know what it's like when you don't have the funds nor the support to really grow your business when you're getting started. Now just keep this in mind. Everybody's space is different. So just what you guys see from what I'll be sharing in today's video, you may not need that, or you may need more of what I show you. But just keep in mind that our spaces are different. So of course, I want you to get the best out of this video by just visualizing what you can start using to start your t-shirt business. So let's go ahead and get this started. Before we get started, I just want to sincerely apologize, y'all, because this is the ugliest like color, I think, as far as this room. Long story short, I kind of wish that they just gave me all white walls, because I just think that it just messes up the flow and I don't like that. So let me just start off with the left hand side. Now I'm gonna hide my board because I don't want y'all seeing my goals and what I got planned, okay? But I got just a whiteboard up here to the left, and then as you guys can see, moving on here, the floating shelves. Highly, okay, that's upside down. That's gonna bother me. Highly recommend that you guys get vertical shelves, or floating shelves, I'm sorry. And the reason being is because when you have a small space, because you cannot really build horizontally, you can build vertically, if that makes sense. So just like floating shelves and things that can help you stay organized, I recommend. I believe I got these from Amazon, and pretty sturdy. I installed them good, because sometimes I have issues with like putting stuff up on walls, but really sturdy. I love them. They come in like longer dimensions, and so just to show y'all from this way, the top one is the longest, middle is like the shortest, and then the really short one at the bottom. So that's like wall stuff and wall space. And then I got this little file thing from, I forget where I got it from, but yeah, I use stuff like that too. And that's about it as far as what I have like on the walls, just because, you know, you live in an apartment, you gotta think about how much you hang up and all that stuff. So okay, so let's get to like the shelves and storage and tables and pretty much everything that you guys are seeing right here. So again, if you are not new here, then seeing this is it's not new for you, I should say. But for those of you who are new here, I got this shelf from, I think, Home Depot, and it was like $25. I'll make sure to find the link if you guys are interested, to where, you know, you can grab it for yourself. But I like it because it's cheap, so it's like really light, and then like you can really like customize the shelves, if that makes sense. So like for example, I had two of these, right? But I broke one down, and just to show y'all what's underneath the table, just to really maximize this space, I broke it down. So now you see I have just like parts of the shelf, and actually I broke it down some more so I could have like two mini shelves. So it was super dope because I didn't have to buy any extra shelving. I just had to break it down, and now I have things that fit there. That's perfect. It clears away the clutter. This room is small. Like, I don't know what it looks like on camera to y'all, but it's small. So I just had to make sure that I didn't have like stuff all over the floor. Like, that would have drove me nuts. So yeah, this shelf I got from either Home Depot or Lowe's, and then I bought two of them. They were like $25. I broke them down to make like mini shelves for things like that. So that is that. So this baby right here is compliments to my best friend. She got this from Amazon. I'll be sure to leave this below, but this is such a good like just space saver for things if you're someone who keeps scraps, and of course just like those miscellaneous items that you're using to make your t-shirts, you kind of want to have it in like arm's reach and just available and accessible. So I recommend like getting something like this. It's super easy to put together. I don't know how much she paid for it, but I was super thankful because I kind of needed something on top top of the table, because at first, before that, y'all, it was a hot mess. Like, I don't even want to talk about it. It was a hot mess. And of course, I have space up top where I have like super color transfers and things like that. So that's more like storage and like putting stuff away. Let's talk about this table though. So this table is from Amazon. I forgot how long it is, but I'm sitting down now. So as you guys can see, like, this is the left side and then boom, this is the right. So I really like, this is all I'm working with. So you guys can see how small of a space it is. Small, but functional. So like, but you can see how I had to really get creative in my tables and what I did, just because I still needed to, you know, function when I had all the orders and I could put the orders like over here on the floor for a little minute, or, you know, extra space on the table. I still needed, like, you know, walking space. I got to be able to film and, you know, all this stuff that you guys really don't see. Like, I just had to make sure my table was just like the right size. And it indeed is. This is one of those like foldable tables. It's like an all-purpose one. Like, you could bring this to like a party, picnics or whatever, but I really like it for what I'm doing, because my cameo fit and my heat press, like, oh, that's a lifesaver for me. Because when I was fulfilling in my house and the way that I would just do it, just like my order of operation, I take everything off the cameo and then I press it, and just everything was just so like fluid and seamless, and I love it. So you see, y'all see what I'm talking about, how it's small but functional. You gotta make sure you get adequate size tables. You may not need this big of a table. You really don't. Amazon has smaller ones, which I'm about to show y'all this one over here. But just to show y'all what it looks like again, y'all can kind of see, you know, how much space it takes up from wall to wall. So from that end to that end. Okay, so again, you're getting a lot of use out of this table if you were to get it, because you can just do so much. Of course, it has like the under, what is it, like the under storage space and stuff like that. Okay, so this like little mini table, it's also like another foldable table that I got from Amazon. I got my printer and just like other business items I thought I was gonna need, and like PR packages from brands I've worked with, all up under this table, just because it helps me save space and I don't have to have it all cluttered and stuff. I was super happy that this fit like perfectly in the corner, y'all. Like, look at that. I didn't have to really do anything. Everything just worked out and I'm so thankful. And let me say this, I am definitely like the one who doesn't measure, so I will blindly just buy something praying that it works. So don't be like me. Measure your space. However, if you don't, then this table is still gonna be good for you. So let's keep going. Yeah, so pretty much from this whole wall, I knew I wanted it to be covered with everything that I'm using for my business, and I think it just worked great. So pretty impressed with how I was able to get everything in here. I've moved this around a few times. Like, this setup hasn't always been what you guys see. Of course, playing around with how it's gonna look in the best way, I did like two moving situations where I moved stuff around, but ultimately this has been like the longest placement of where everything is. And then you guys know, like, when it comes to making sure your stuff is by like outlets and stuff, you want to make sure like there's outlets behind the table. Y'all just can't see, there's an outlet right there for the printer. I kept that in mind too, because I'm like, well, if I'm going to be using my printer, gotta make sure it's by an outlet, gotta make sure it's by all that stuff. So again, small but functional. So bear with me, you guys, because I know this looks really crazy right now, but this is how I pretty much just like it's hiding up this little crazy corner of mine, just because my closet, which I'm not gonna show y'all that today, because listen, we gonna be here all day. But as far as like extra space, I ran out in the closet, so I had to pretty much like compact stuff that I'm not using and like shove over to this corner. So the only thing that I really want to point out to you guys is this organizing shelf that I also got from Amazon, and I love it when it comes to putting like extra scraps of vinyl in there. Like, there you go, all that stuff. I got so much stuff in here that I've used. I used as far as making videos. Like, I still use these things in these drawers. So I really like how it just came with so many, so I can have ample space to put all of my crafts and paper supplies and things like that. So I highly recommend this. Honestly, this and this, I highly recommend first, just because you can work off to see how much space you'll have. At least get yourself a table if you don't, and also get yourself something to keep everything organized. The last thing you need is a small and cluttered space, and you can't operate in that. All right, y'all, so you guys might have saw this in my vlog when I like redid this room and just got so much more supplies, but this is like this customizable metal storage bins, but then they come to where you can just connect them by this little divot right here, and then you can like build. So it's kind of like storage building blocks, if you ask me, like storage building cubes or something. I love this thing. I love this so much. When I was fulfilling, you know, you guys, look how I kept stuff organized, even though the t-shirts look crazy, but I kept it. I had a system. Like I think I did small, medium, large, extra large, 2XL, and then extra stuff down there. So this is the bee's knees. So this and that and that are like my most favorite pieces in here, just because, man, when you have so many t-shirts and you have blanks, you're gonna need somewhere to store them, and you're gonna want to stay organized. So, and even, you know, you have storage above it here too. So, man, you guys, there's so many options when it comes to creating a t-shirt shop in a small space. And just before I end this video, I'm gonna give y'all one more full look so that way you can see how everything looks again. Good people, so that ends today's video on how to start your t-shirt shop at home, specifically if you have a small space. Everything will be listed in the description box below. If you remember, everyone starts out from somewhere. I don't care if you are working out of a little section in your studio apartment, you can still operate a business and then you just grow from there. Before I let you go, I just wanted to let you guys know that you can still book your consultation calls with me, so that way you can get started today. Okay, I have 30-minute and 1-hour consultation call. If you need help outside of the videos, then go ahead and book a consultation so me and you can have that one-on-one time to help you get started, okay? But as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to drink your water, mind your business, and always choose yourself first, and I'll be back in my next video. Bye, y'all.